AIDS didn't just happen, it was allowed to happen.
Essentially, Gaetan in Vancouver was the personage, the face of AIDS.
Killing Patient Zero is a portrait of Gaetan Dugas, a French-Canadian flight attendant who became widely known as the man almost single-handedly responsible for the AIDS epidemic in North America. This after his role in the story of the disease was misreported in the groundbreaking 1987 book And the Band Played On, Politics, People, and the AIDS Epidemic.
I told him, no, don't do this. This is not a good idea. You shouldn't name Patient Zero.
Now filmmaker Lori Lind is rehabilitating the public image of Dugas, making a case for how he became a scapegoat and making clear that the man known as Patient Zero did not cause the epidemic, but was one of its victims.
I thought like, oh, who's this poor guy that they're trying to blame this all on?
What did you know about Gaetan Dugas and the idea of Patient Zero?
I first read And the Band Played On when it came out, and I had just moved back to Toronto from New York City. I went to film school and went to NYU. 82 to 86, I was living in New York, like the height of the AIDS years. And it was reading And the Band Played On that basically woke me up. AIDS is not being given the attention it deserved because it was only affecting gay men and intravenous drug users. So all the people who seemed to be getting the disease were considered undesirables and no one seemed to care. That's how the Patient Zero story started. And I'm embarrassed to say when I read Randy's book then, I bought his description of Gaetan Dugas, because in the book he creates this character who's almost like a vampire who's willfully spreading the disease, which is completely untrue. People forget being openly gay back in the 80s and 70s was a courageous thing, and I always intended it to be an overview of what the gay experience was then. Have people understand what we queer people from that period, what we've lived through, and not to forget it, because you know, a Holocaust was allowed to happen to gay men in the 80s and early 90s because it didn't seem to matter.